Savior Jesus Christ, and I welcome you to worship on this Christmas Eve. Glad that you are able to join us. A special welcome to visitors we have with us this evening, as well as those of you who are joining us on our YouTube channel. We're glad that you're able to join us even through technology. The announcements, the liturgy, I should say, for tonight is found in your worship guide. It's in the front part, and the announcements are in the back part. Today's announcements are focused on the many ministries we do here at St. Paul to give you a taste of what the congregation does. One correction needs to be made on the calendar on the back page. The annual meeting should be January 30th, not the day listed. A reminder that we are in the midst of the pandemic still, and as a congregation, we remain concerned for the most vulnerable among us. Wayne County is currently at a high transmission level, which corresponds to phase 4 of our worship protocol. This means no congregational singing. Cantors and musicians will lead us in the hymn sing in the many carols that we hear tonight. The liturgy is spoken, and the bold part are your parts. We're seated during the hymns, so take the time to listen to the words and to reflect on their meaning. At the end of our service, we'll do a candlelight service, and I will give you more instruction as we get to that point. Thank you so very much to all of you who have donated a poinsettia to adorn the chancel area. It's beautiful. And if you did donate a flower, please remember to bring it home after worship tonight. And finally, thank you to our handbell choirs, our cantors, and our musicians who will enrich our worship service, sharing the gift of music with us this evening. Our service begins with the gathering hymn, O Come, O Ye Faithful.
Oh,
grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Let us pray. Almighty God, you made this holy night shine with the brightness of the true light. Grant that here on earth we may walk in the light of Jesus' presence, and in the last day wake to the brightness of his glory. Through your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. May be seated.
to Luke, the second chapter. Glory to you, O Lord. In those days, a decree went out from Emperor Augustus that all the world should be registered. This was the first registration and was taken while Quirinius was governor of Syria. All went to their own towns to be registered. Joseph also went from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to the city of David called Bethlehem, because he was descended from the house and family of David. He went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged and who was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for her to deliver her child, and she gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in bands of cloth and laid him in a manger because there was no place for them in the inn. In that region, there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. Then an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all the people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign for you. You will find the child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven and on earth among those whom he favors." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go now to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us." So they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph, and the child lying in the manger. When they saw this, they made known what had been told them about this child, and all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds told them. But Mary treasured all these words and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen, as it had been told them. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
Christmas Eve is a day we celebrate and try to make sense of the mystery of how a baby in a manger from such a long time ago can have such an impact on our lives and on our world today. On this Christmas Eve, much like other Christmas Eves, yet with social distancing and cantor singing as we are in the grips of the COVID pandemic, people from all walks of life have come here all day to St. Paul in all three services, the rich and the poor, those who are happy and those who are sad, those who feel nervous about the spread of COVID and Omicron, and those who want to take off the mask and sing in full voice, those who celebrate a healing and those who are hurting. All of us are here in person, and some of you are through social media on your YouTube channel to read Luke's Gospel birth narrative, and in doing so, search for something that the world out there cannot give us. So why is it such a mystery? And why do we want to grasp hold of it year after year? I think the reason most of us come in search for the solution to this mystery, in search of hope, in search of this light of the world, is this simple reality. And that reality is that it's in this simple story of an ordinary family having what is seemingly an ordinary baby, we can all connect with the story on a personal level. We can connect to the story of Joseph, Mary, and baby Jesus because the first Christmas was much like you and me. It was far from perfect. And is that not the truth this year? Those involved in that first Christmas were people who had their own problems. They lived in a country occupied by a foreign army. They were forced to travel to another city. Then, when they got there, there was no room for them in the inn. Then there was the birth. And so what we who are here today need to make sure of is that in the midst of the hustle and bustle of the season, the candle lighting and the shopping, the dinners and the gift giving, We don't ever trivialize the story of Jesus Christ to be just the story of his birth, a story about this babe in the manger. But sadly, people seem to do just that, trivialize the story of Jesus Christ to be just a story about his birth. But if we do that, then we make Christ totally irrelevant to our lives today, for our lives, and in our lives. If we trivialize the story of Jesus Christ to be just about his birth, we will find no hope in the story, because we will not understand how this story connects to our lives today, here at Grosse Pointe Farms, Michigan, at the end of the year 2021. So the reality is that the very hope in the Christmas story is that this is a story that is relevant to our everyday life today and beyond. It is relevant because Jesus did grow up and he became a man fulfilling God's mission. So that means that the real experience of Christmas is not in the babe in the manger, but comes in what Jesus did as a grown-up with people in everyday life situations, as he proclaimed the kingdom of God is at hand. Experiences like the healing of the blind man who was born blind in John 9, the conversation with the outcast woman at the well in John's Gospel chapter 4, or the parables he taught people with, parables like the one about the Good Samaritan in Luke's Gospel chapter 10, or the famous prodigal son in Luke 15. The babe in the manger became a man and brought the hope of that newborn to the real world in a very real way. And that's our hope for today. As Christmas came to the people in Bethlehem some 2,000 years ago, Christmas comes to us this year too. It comes into an imperfect world. It comes into our imperfect lives. But the good news in this story is not the birth of baby Jesus. The good news is that God still comes to us, even after all these years. Even in the midst of the darkness of our lives, in this world we live in today. God comes in ways that are as unimaginable as a baby born in Bethlehem. God comes in small ways to touch our own brokenness. God comes in perfect ways to touch our imperfection. God comes in less than powerful ways to touch our less powerful selves. God comes to bring us hope in a life that may be filled with hopelessness or despair, sickness or brokenness in so many other ways. Jesus came to this earth so that he can be here in the midst of our everyday lives. His birth is the birth of hope and peace in our everyday life, no matter how burdened down we are. So at the heart of the Christmas story, what we truly have to look forward to and get excited about is hearing again the story of the Savior's birth. But it's not just the birth of a Savior, it's the birth of our Savior, the birth of Jesus the Christ. And so as we hear the Christmas story again for the first time this day, may our hearts be warmed to the hope this story brings to our lives. May we find the courage to be guided by this light in the year to come. May the presence and loving mystery of Jesus himself be reborn in our lives once again. May the world, so in need of love and peace, come to realize that this is found for our lives and for our world in this very child, Jesus the Christ, the light of the world, the ones whose birth we celebrate today, the one for whom we can only say, thanks be to God.
Thank you.
Baptist Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended from the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Joining our voices with the heavenly host and Christians throughout time and space, let us pray for the church, the world, and all in need.
Love proclaims that a Savior has been born to us. Inspire your church throughout the world to proclaim the good news of Jesus' birth to all who seek salvation, hope, and new life. Lord, in your mercy. Love whispers to a weary world that the time for patience and comfort has come. Be with those separated from loved ones and with congregations revising and canceling plans in order to stay healthy during this season of COVID. Comfort everyone who envisioned this holiday season differently than how it turned out. Lord, in your mercy. Love cries to a warring world that the time for peace is at hand. Direct those in power who make decisions on behalf of others that they nurture and sustain all that is healthy, good, and holy. Lord, in your mercy. Love sings through the wails of a newborn baby. Respond to all who cry out in pain, despair, or need this night, especially Sue, Greg, Anitra, Henry, Jean, Ellen, Betty, Mary, Sarah, Linda, Nancy, Richard, Jackie, Bob, Matthew, Anna, Patty, Ken, Bill, Connie, Reverend Lauren, Paul, Camille, Trish, Reverend Sarah, Leela, Georgine, Fred, Fern, Mary, Jerry, Kathy, Earl, Paul, Janice, Harry, Lucille, Eleanor, Carl, Molly, John, and Jeff. Bring comfort to those for whom separation, grief, or loss makes the Christmas season especially difficult. Lord, in your mercy. Love murmurs words of comfort to a newborn child and exhausted parents. Bless new and expectant parents or caregivers, especially those who are alone or afraid this night. Pour out your love upon families of every kind. Lord, in your mercy. Love provides guidance through the Holy Spirit. Guide the Evangelical Lutheran Church in America, our National Bishop Elizabeth, our Southeast Michigan Synod, and its Bishop Donald in your ways of love. Hear our prayers for all congregations in our conference, thinking today especially of Bethlehem Lutheran Church in Harrison Township and their licensed lay minister, Robert Brannon. Lord, in your mercy. God's ever-present love is proclaimed through the faithful who came before us. We give you thanks for Mary, John the Baptizer, Elizabeth his mother, Joseph the dreamer, and all who point toward your love. Lord, in your mercy.
Rejoicing in the Word made flesh among us, we commend these prayers to you, confident of your grace and love made known to us in Jesus Christ our Savior. Amen. Amen. The peace of Christ be with you always.
And also with you.
COVID time, we do the peace of Christ with each other like this way.
Let us pray. God with us, you came as a baby to a manger. You slept on straw and greeted shepherds. You come again in bread and wine. Remind us how good you are at blessing ordinary things. And then, through these gifts, help us to bless the lives of others in the strength of your holy name.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks in Christ.
It is indeed right, our duty, our joy, that we should at all times and in all places give thanks and praise to you, almighty and merciful God, through our Savior, Jesus Christ. In the wonder and mystery of the Word made flesh, you have opened the eyes of faith to a new and radiant vision of your glory, that beholding the God made visible, we may be drawn to love the God whom we cannot see. And so with all the choirs of angels, with the church on earth and the host of heaven, we praise your name and join the unending hymn, saying, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest, Hosanna in the highest. Holy One, the beginning and the end, the giver of life, blessed are you for the birth of creation. Blessed are you in the darkness and in the light. Blessed are you for your promise to your people. Blessed are you in the prophets' hopes and dreams. Blessed are you for Mary's openness to your will. Blessed are you for your son Jesus, the Word made flesh. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread and gave thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me. Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me. Let us proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ is
alive. Christ is risen. Christ will come again.
With this bread and cup, we remember the Lord, Word dwelling among us, full of grace and truth. We remember our new birth in his death and resurrection. We look for hope in for his coming. Come, Lord Jesus. Holy God, we long for your Spirit. Come among us. Bless this meal. May your word take flesh in us. Awaken your people. Fill us with your light. Bring the gift of peace on earth.
Come, Holy Spirit.
All praise and glory are yours, Holy One of Israel, Word of God incarnate, power of the Most High, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
As Jesus taught us, we pray, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. The gifts of God for the people of God. You may be seated, and I would invite you to take out the individual chalice-like cup that we received on the way, and you turn it up so that the bread is on top, and then you pull the lever over and take out the bread. And then we say the body of Christ given for you. Turn it upside down again so that you have the wine on top. Otherwise, you're going to have the wine on your knees. And then we'll pull the tab back and we'll drink. And we'll say, the blood of Christ shed for you. So I invite you to rise. The body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you in his grace. Amen.
Let us pray. On this day, O God, you gave us Christ the Son to save us. As you foretold, send us now with the good news for all people. Let the gladness of this feast have no end as we share with others the joy that fills us. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen.
Amen. You may be seated, and I would invite you to take out your candles. And if you are sitting closest to the center aisle, please take a candle and light it on one of the torches and then pass it down. The entire part of this service is on one page, so there will never be a need to turn the page. So we read the scripture responsibly. The Lord, the people who walk in darkness have seen a great light.
The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness has not overcome.
Those who live in the land of deep darkness, on them has light shined. Child has been born for us, a son given to us. Today Christ is born. Today salvation has appeared.
Glory be to God, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty God, you made this holy night shine with the brightness of the true light. We give you thanks for the gift of Jesus, whom you sent to save us. We praise your name and tell the earth this story, that all may believe, rejoice, and bow down, acknowledging your love, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Thank you.
May you be filled with the wonder of Mary, the obedience of Joseph, the joy of the angels, the eagerness of the shepherds, the determination of the Magi, and the peace of the Christ child. Almighty Father, God, Almighty God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, bless you now and forever.
Thank you. I You're finding goodies too.
Yes.
Thank you. You know, good luck to the line.
As we say in joke, you haven't seen the Lions games and lose properly.
Exactly.
It's great to see you guys.